Yeah, this is Gilbert.
I'm Sebastian. We are Crystal Fighters. You're watching mk.co.za.
Is there any amount of money or charity cause in the world that would make the Crystal Fighters shave their heads clean?
I mean, yeah, definitely. There are lots of charitable causes. If someone asked me to do it, I probably would consider it if there was a lot of money going. David Wolf's charity, which is to plant 18 million fruit trees around the earth. 18 billion. Everyone thinks it's about war, about politics. Actually, it's about the food we eat and the things that we're told to consume on a daily basis by all these companies which are basically shoveling like poison into our throats every day.
Johannesburg. When you guys first heard you were coming to the city of
Tell us.
What was your initial reaction? Were you scared because of the infamous crime rate, which is mostly perpetuated by Capetonians? Or were you just excited of, you know, having the opportunity to visit the city of gold?
Anywhere, you should be aware of yourself and what you're doing and who you're with and whatever, you know, that's obviously logic. So it's all about people and meeting people and connecting with people and seeing this culture, you know, like that was the most exciting thing for me. Most of our last album was inspired by the idea that we all came from South Africa.
It's all about going back to the idea of the first moment of creation, not of like humankind, but when humans first made art and when they first gathered together, you know, probably in the dark, probably in a cave to play music, to, you know, there's evidence to show that there are like sweet spots in caves sonically, and a lot of like remains and paintings are found in these sonic sweet spots. So it's like, it's kind of caves have always been at the center of enlightenment kind of thing. And so rave is the modern thing.
How many years did it take you guys to master the Basque instruments before you had enough courage to start a band and actually drop your first album, Love Light, Love Star?
Star of Love.
We found it didn't take too long to get, you know, basic grip of it and to have enough confidence to play it. But it's more like it's something that takes years to master. And, you know, we're fortunate enough to know some of the best players in the world of these instruments. So we've been able to learn from them and to see them play. We've actually had them come and play with us on the road as well, which is kind of cool. And yeah, it just takes time, like any new instrument. And you know, we're still learning, you know, we're still learning about new instruments as well. So it's all like a big sort of like fun creative journey for us, like learning about these things and trying them out, mixing them with like different types of music and just seeing what happens and just try to have a good time at the same time.
You cancelled a lot of shows, but you kept rocking the Daisies, you kept Vodacom in the city. Why did you decide to come to South Africa and cancel all the other shows?
It was just a time thing at the time, you know, we need time to, you know, to grieve about these things, and you know, none of us would have been able to do any of those shows. It just, you know, these were enough time away, you know, for us to get ourselves together. And you know, we've rescheduled some of the shows we've had to miss. And you know, we as I said, we just want to, you know, keep spreading our message with music, and because it's a positive one, and that helps us, you know, get through all this. But it's a country, you know, steeped in a very, you know, long history. Being here is amazing to feel the totally different vibe, like totally different content. But it's come a long way, you know, from where it was, at least, you know. So that if things can just keep moving in the right direction for South Africans, and so for prosperity for everyone to increase, and you know.
Why haven't you guys featured a single rapper in any of your songs?
We're just waiting for ASAP to call, you know. Kendrick, I mean, you know, we're buddies, but he don't want to get jump on the track. No. I mean, maybe one day.
It's a stylistic thing, like we thought we'd do our style for at least two records, you know, like try and make that style.
You guys rap?
Yeah, I'm not going to now, but... No, he used to rhyme on drum and bass all the time, like he can rap.
Thank you to you guys. Thanks to everyone in South Africa for having us. It's an awesome place, we can't wait to be back here. Today was awesome, rocking the days is going to be fun as well. And it's just a privilege to be here, so we're really thankful.
Yeah, you know, this is obviously a very sad time for all of us in the band and anyone who knew Andrea. And, you know, it was a tough decision to, you know, carry on the group at all. Previously, it was just me, Gilbert and Graham on stage, no drummer, not even a girl singer at certain times. And when he came along and Ellie got involved, and, you know, it completely shifted around. Everyone we meet here is cool, and it's all good. And we're around friends and family wherever we go, so... Couldn't be happier, and much love.